Salam Aleikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace and blessings and God's mercy be upon you all. Today I wanted to share a reminder of the importance of intentions, niyya. Why are they so important and how much of a role do they play within our lives? How much should we check ourselves for our intentions? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that innama al-a'malu binniyat, truly deeds are by intention. Now, that tells me that every action has an intention. And if you really reflect, even those who say or make the claim that I just do things nilly-willy, right? Just for whatever reason. If you really take that extra moment to realize why you're internally doing this, you'll find that there is always an intention, whether you're aware of it or not. That's the first point. So everything that we do has an intention. For the believer, or the one who submits their will to God and tries to live their life according to God, every aspect of the believer's life has to do with worship. Even walking to the bathroom out, having sexual intercourse with your significant other, drinking water. Everything can be made into an act of worship if you know its ruling or the manner that you should approach it, and you understand what you're doing. So in terms of the intention, we should always do it for the sake of Allah. Now, Allah gives the example of the action that is done and how we should react to it. For example, if you go and you donate to your family member, for example, you do something kind for your family members. And I say that because in terms of the charity obligations, al-aqrabun, those who are close, kindred, ties, family members, take a priority on that list. So I'll use that as the first example. So I donate $100 to my relative who's a widow who needs money. And then I follow that action with evil. Not necessarily to another person or just like doing something else that's haram, but harm to that person that I have given the donation to. Where, it, you know, the expression of twisting one's arm. Like, I've donated, I helped you, so therefore you have to listen to me, right? The real question is then, what was your intention of donating? Was it really then for the sake of Allah, right? And how we can erase the intention. It may be proper in the beginning, but now because of what we said, the intentions have changed. The same thing happens of why we do things in our life. I go help my family members with doing the dishes. Well, I did the dishes, so you have to do it now. No, you did it for the sake of Allah, so it doesn't matter. Right? You seek your reward from Allah. So intentions, if we don't pay attention with our words, can get corrupted. And they could lead us to a sin called riya', which is hidden shirk, associating partners with God. And that's not the physical where you're worshipping a statue, a cow, or a human being, or whatever. It's more of an internal self-glorification, or your amazement of self-praise. And this is why, the Prophet ﷺ and the early companions were not pleased with self-praise. And there's an expression that says, you know, self-praising a person too much, you're actually killing them. Or you're killing their... you're suppressing their true self and increasing in their ego, where someone's like, ha ha ha, look at me, I go and donate every day, you know, or dying, you know, as the hadith says, the first three people to enter the hellfire is a hafiz, someone who memorized the Quran, someone who gave in charity, someone who went out for jihad, physical jihad in terms of war. And when the companions asked how, because these are all righteous actions, he replied, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that basically, it's a long hadith, I'm just going to summarize it. But the conversations they have with Allah will say to the person who gave charity, for example, what did you do with the wealth that I've given you? He will say, I've donated it for your sake. And Allah will say, you're a liar. You've donated it so the people can say that you are a charitable person. You can obviously get the understanding of about the person who's a knowledgeable scholar and the person who went out for the sake of Allah. It's for the same reasons they wanted self-glorification. And you kind of see that a lot. And this is why, honestly, I was really scared of posting videos online. And, you know, the solution to it, what I find is making dua before you even begin this thing. About you know, for Allah to bless it, to purify your intentions and to set expectations of your reward that has nothing to do with worldly things, appreciation or glorification or awareness, but for Allah to increase you and bless you in that reward. And for it, for example, in this video, I asked Allah to bless as many hearts and to guide as many hearts to do righteous actions and to give me a fraction of that portion of whoever. You know, a little bit of greed there of wanting more from Allah, not from you guys. So do as you wish. So, you know, I think it's important to have proper intentions. Now, Allah gives the example of someone who plants a seed, for example. He gives the example of a dry hill, a hill. And on that hill, it's basically dry. And when it rains hard, no matter how many seeds you plant, it won't vegetate. And he, that example is basically like giving someone a good deed, and you're, like I said, an example of your relative, you're following it with harm. So it removes the benefit out of the good deed that you have done. And in terms of following it with good, Allah says it gives the example of like a rain that increases the reward twice. And obviously Allah says in the Quran, and he gives or rewards as many as he wants, basically. And to give you a real life example of why intentions are so important, no matter how small your actions, is imagine you donated a dollar to a homeless man or person, and that person ends up accepting Islam, becoming the biggest scholar in the world, guides many people, becomes wealthy, and donates all that money. So you get the reward of all of that for that single dollar. To you, it might have been small, but your intention was like, I really hope this person gets it and does good, right? And ya Allah, please accept it from me. It's not much, it's all I have, right? Versus a person who donates $1 million. $1 million, but his intentions are wrong, so it becomes fruitless. It becomes dry, right? So intentions are very important, and never, you know, think about the reward when your intentions are pure, because it will always be beyond your imagination, right? So intentions, and always check yourself. Always take the extra thought to make sure that your intention of why you're doing things is proper. Because of course you want your actions to be fruitful and blessed, inshallah. May Allah accept from me and you, and make us amongst those who are rightly guided, and make us of those who don't follow their good actions with men wa'adha, basically hurt and this, you know, causing the people harm that we do the good for. May Allah protect us and our actions and our intentions. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.